Well, good evening and welcome. Welcome to our community update and prayer. And yes, let the church say amen. Welcome, I'm Bishop Desmond, and welcome to our community update and prayer from Vision Temple of Praise. And I just want to say a big hi going out to each and every one and say the Lord richly bless you this evening. And, you know, one of the things that we must always remember is this, you know, we're here every single day for a purpose and to make a difference. Today, we handed myself and colleagues 18 bleed control kits over to Birmingham Youth Services as a donation towards what's happening on our streets. And we'll be arranging training for them as well, in terms of the bleed control kits which were handed over today. In addition to that as well, we publicized a couple of weapons that we had handed in recently, and they were handed in to us. They were put in weapon surrender bins. And what we wanted to do was get that message out that, hey, you know, get the message out there. Hey, listen up, you know, the message is filtering through, not at the pace that we probably want it to do, but what we need to be doing is to remember that, you know, we have to all the time seek to be making a difference. And that's what we need to do. We just need to make that all important difference. And let us just not forget who we are, what we need to do, and let us just focus upon the journey ahead, because that's the only way we are going to make a difference. Now, importantly as well, something is happening quite important in our city Birmingham. And for a long time, many, as usual, have been asleep to what is happening. And I'm going to be honest with you, it is of concern. And it is of concern because we always leave things until the horse has bolted. On the 1st of June, we will have the clean air zone in our city. And this clean air zone will mean that if you travel within the inner ring of Birmingham, an example of this to describe it to you are parts, the main chunks of the number 8 bus route, the inner circle. You will have to pay £8. And some of the poorest parts of Birmingham have been included in this. Now, I'm not stigmatizing an area where people live. Let me make that clear. However, places like Highgate, Boughton Square, Stanhope Street, Darwin Street in Highgate, St Luke's Road where they're building new houses, Gooch Street, South Acre Avenue. If you want to turn down into any of those roads, which is just outside the city centre, you will have to pay £8 if you're driving what they call a non-compliant vehicle. If you're driving a much larger vehicle, you'll have to pay more money than that. When you come along Watery Lane, for example, turning into Digbeth, you're going to have to pay if you're driving what they call a non-compliant vehicle. If you carry on from there, you drive up towards what we call the Matalan roundabout. So turning, if you have to go to the council office in Woodcock Street and your car's non-compliant, you'd have to pay £8. Effectively as well, to go into town. So say, for example, we're now going to travel to South Birmingham. We can no longer use Queensway Tunnel if your vehicle's not compliant. You'd have to drive round, for example. Because Queensway Tunnel is within the clean air zone. So you'd have to find an alternative route. And the alternative route will be New John Street West. You can't go into parts of Newtown anymore without having to pay. So even one of the mechanics that look after my car, effectively, I would have to pay to go to his garage. Along New John Street West, you've got Newtown, St. George's Estate on the left, which is Teviot Tower, for example, Schofield Tower, Ray Tower, and all of Great Hampton Row there. To turn into there to deliver our food parcels, for example, to over 60 families, we're going to have to pay £8 for our van to go there to deliver. When I asked about this, I was told, well, you'll have to buy a more compliant van. What's more important, buying a new van? The van we've got is a 60 plate. But we're going to have to look at buying a new van so that we don't have to pay to deliver food parcels. Every week, £8. So we go along there, round into McNeil Street, up to Spring Hill, along the dual carriageway. We turn into the jewellery quarter. Driving a non-compliant vehicle, you have to pay £8. Then we go across Spring Hill roundabout. If we want to turn and go to the NIA, we've got to pay £8. You then come up to Ladywood Middleway, St. Mark's Crescent. You have to pay £8. To go to any of the shops there, you've got to pay £8. Great Lister Street, you've got to pay £8. Great Tyndall Street. And then we go back round towards Five Ways and Naya, the gentleman who owns Granny's Takeaway, said to me, Desmond, this thing is just so unfair because it could put me out of business. Because imagine, soup is £3-4. And some people come here to buy soup. There's no way for them to park outside that middle way, because anyone knows part of Ladywood, they've covered it with residential parking. And there's no tangible car park for people to place the people to park to go across the road. So therefore, people would have, who's going to pay £8 to buy soup for £4? So when everyone thinks about what they're doing, when those in power think about what they're doing, who are you impacting upon? Now we hear clean air, saving lives. Of course, what other steps could have been taken apart from getting money off the motorist yet again? The city centre, parts of it may well become ghost towns. Because do you know why? The transport links into the city centre aren't the greatest. You know that, I know that. We're just coming out of COVID. Many people, we were told at one point by the Prime Minister, do not use public transport. You remember that, don't you? We were told, don't use public transport. But the clean air zone starts on the 1st of June. But who's thought about the impact upon the people? Now, we understand that, there will be, exemptions. We understand, for people in the areas for 12 months. Someone's told me today they've got a 12-month exemption. When we delivered the food parcels in our vans, you know what we were told? We were told when we delivered them, we had a letter. And the letter came and said, you will have to get a more compliant vehicle or pay £8. Now, £8 doesn't sound a lot to some people, but to some people it's a heck of a lot. You can go to Aldi and get a lot for £8. And when we're doing food parcels, we can go to Aldi and get a lot for £8. So the point I'm making is that who is considering these? Who's really thinking about this? Who's making the decisions? Have the people really been consulted? Why is it that you're starting to cut off some of the people in some of the what we call areas of Birmingham where inequality is so high? Who's bothered to talk to them? Relatives visiting, car non-compliant, will have to pay £8 to visit a relative, for example. That's the point of what's happening here. What's the reason behind all of this? What's the thinking behind all of it? And that's the thing. What is the thinking? What is what can we do and what can't we do? That's the key element here. Now, moving forward, what can we do? You've got to start talking, you know, it's going to happen on the 1st of June. And if you don't pay this fee, then I'm assuming it's going to increase and you'll end up getting penalties. And when you get penalties, you could ultimately end up with bailiffs on your doorsteps, just like for parking tickets, for example. And we know what happens when they turn up, you know. We know what happens when they turn up, don't we? So the whole issue is this. There's a government checker online. What I suggest you do is just type in Birmingham Clean Air Zone and go and have a look. Now, the Birmingham Mail issued an article last week and it talks about exemptions last week, Friday. So if you go to the Birmingham Life site and look up the Clean Air Zone article, it tells you how to get your exemptions. And one of the things we're going to be doing in the coming week is ensuring that we publicize what the exemptions are and how you get those exemptions, because clearly we need to do that as well, moving everything forward. Therefore then, so that's where we are at the moment with the Clean Air Zone. Now, we're gonna crank this up, but clearly we must remember one thing. Next year there are elections locally in Birmingham and you will have choices just like anyone else. And your choices are there that need to be made. So therefore, right, the important thing is what you need to do is to think carefully. Because you see, remember, when you don't go out and vote, when you're not even registered to vote, when you keep voting in the same patterns, your vote becomes worthless. And ultimately, you don't matter. That's what happens. But with We Matter, you of course matter. If I matter, you matter. Your neighbor matters, we all matter. But importantly, what I am saying to you this evening is this. We all matter. We all have a voice. It's time to step up and have your voice heard. When I see councillors becoming MPs and not giving up their council seats and receiving their allowance for being a councillor and receiving their MP salary alongside their allowances to run their MP offices, and they can be and remain an MP for 2, 3, even 4 years. Sorry, a councillor for that time before, you know, they can sit out their term of office. The only condition is, I believe, that they have to attend a council meeting once every 12 months. That's wrong. That's wrong. That's reprehensible. As soon as a councillor becomes an MP, a councillor should be giving up that seat. I know that there are 3 councillors at Birmingham City Council who are now members of parliament. Why don't you give up those seats? Give them up. Let the by-elections take place and get people in who can get on with it. You've been blessed to move on. You've been blessed to become a member of parliament. Why is it that you want to remain a sitting councillor when someone else could be getting on with the job of running community forums, running forums for the local people, running the surgeries, and importantly, having a better, greater idea of what's happening? I know we've got a councillor at Castle Vale who's an MP. We know we've got a councillor in King Standing who's an MP. We know we've got a councillor in Neatchells who is an MP. We know the elections are next March, but there were by-elections in the elections which had just gone. Why did they not give up their seats and let those by-elections take place? It's time to take stock. Because really, who are you serving? Are you serving the people or are you there to be served? Now, I know that some of these people, They're good councillors, and I'm sure there's some of them are very good MPs. But come on, guys, you don't need to hang on to two offices. Come on. All this does is increase the mass disaffection that we already have. And it sends a clear message that we just don't matter. But today, We Matter is here. And we want to bring on those changes. And importantly, next week, Thursday, the 27th of May, is our public meeting. If you go to our website, www.wematterparty.org, you'll be able to pick the link up there for our public meeting. If you go to our Twitter page, you will pick the meeting up there. If you go to our Facebook page, you will pick it up there as well. Do go there, join our meeting, have your say. It's important that you come to that meeting, because in order to make representations, we have to know what the temperature is. We want to know how you feel, and we have to ensure that the changes that we are seeking have your support. And that's next week, Thursday, on Zoom. And we'll be having face-to-face as soon as we're out of lockdown. We'll find venues and we'll call you to public face-to-face meetings, because we all want to make that all-important difference, because we matter. Tomorrow evening, on Zoom, is the Windrush National Organisation meeting. It's a public forum, and it's a series of our monthly public engagement meetings with the Home Office. This is probably one of the most important meetings that we've held to date, because on this meeting, there will be the senior decision makers from the Home Office, the senior decision makers that deal with status, the senior decision makers that deal with passports, senior decision makers who are there also in terms of working on the implementation of the new immigration rules. But importantly, they will be there as well to explain the potential impact on Windrush. Now, importantly, over the past few months, people have been saying, well, that person got that decision. I'm in the same boat as them and I was turned down. Up to yesterday, I heard the same thing. And I'm encouraging you to register and attend that meeting. Attend it regarding status, attend it regarding citizenship, attend it regarding getting your British passport. The officials coming to this meeting tomorrow on behalf of the Home Office, all of them are very senior civil servants. They are bosses. They are in decision-making arenas. You need to attend. You need to be heard. I can't stress it enough. Now, how do you attend? You go to the website www.windrushnationalorganization.com. You go to the website, you register your right to attend, and the link will be sent to you. Some links have gone out today already. Links will go out to you. Receive links by lunchtime tomorrow to attend the Zoom meeting. Now, I'm just going to share this with you, okay? Many people have said to me, why do you have to do that? Because every time we have the meeting, we will just have one link and we'd publicize it. Every time we've had the meetings, when the links have been out, we have people coming to the meetings and people start having a go with racial abuse, etc. Now, I have a message to those people who do that. We will track you down and we will ensure that the police have your details. Our meetings are recorded as a matter of public record, but importantly, we will be recording you, we'll get your pictures, and we will hand those to the police as well. So clearly, we will let you know on that. Now, moving forward, what we will then do in terms of moving forward is we record the meetings. It's a matter of public record. But importantly as well, what we do in terms of moving forward is that any questions that people have, we do record them and we do put them on our website. So they do go on the website, and then the question and answers go on our website, and in that the Home Office, once they provide the answers, they're published, and then it becomes a point of reference for all the information that is there, because the answers are provided by the Home Office directly. So very much that's where we're at. But importantly, sitting back and doing nothing is no longer a problem. It's time to rise up and make that all important difference. And what we need to do is to make sure that we rise up. I mean, right now we're like Lazarus, aren't we? You know, some of us, you know, we're just dead spiritually. It's time now to rise up. Like when Jesus rose Lazarus up from the dead. And what we need to do is start ensuring that we wake up to the realization that we all matter. And that's what we've got to do. We have to wake up to that realization that we all matter. And that's the thing. You know, just like the sun, imagine if the sun did not rise during the day, we would be in darkness, would we not? Just imagine if the moon didn't rise up at night, we'd be pitch black outside, you wouldn't be able to see anything. Just imagine if the street lights weren't working, we'd be in darkness. It's time now that we stop sitting down and that we rise up. It is time now that we wake up to the realization that we all matter. It's time now that we wake up to the realization that God has a plan for each of us. Psalms 139 reminds us, you know when I sit and when I rise, you understand my thoughts afar. We must remember as well that although God knows your heart, what's in your heart, sometimes you have to expose that. You have to expose that. And remember this, sitting down and sitting back and doing nothing is no longer an option. It's now time to make an important difference. It's time now for God's people to move forward. It's time now for God's people to step up to the mark. It's time now for you to do what is right in the sight of God. And we will be doing that. We will be moving forward, and we will be making that all important difference. So as we close this update this evening, let us just work together and let us remember that we matter. And remember, we're here to look out for one another. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we give you the glory and the praise this evening. We thank you for bringing us together. Father, whilst others sometimes seek to hold our head on the water, Father, we pray, let us rise up now as a people. Let us link arms together, Father, and let us visualize, prioritize, and energize and transform our society, Father. Transform our society to be inclusive. Let us step and walk together in love and unity. Father, let no weapon formed against your people prosper. Father, we pray for our spirits. We pray for our youth, Father. We pray for those in authority, Father. My God, there are times, Father, when we feel it is so difficult, Father, because the more we pray, Father, the more we need to pray. Because there are times, Father, that man feels that they are greater than you. And Father, we need to break that barrier down. Father, the words and the messages are getting through. But Father, there are times when the race, those that seek to oppress are way ahead of us. But Father, we know by the faith we have in you, we know by the belief we have in you, Father, that those stepping stones, Father, that we are taking right now will become great steps. They will become great leaps, and we will overtake, Father, and block the plan of the enemy. We will take over, Father, and block the plan of the oppressor. Father, we will bulldoze the uneven playing fields. We will bulldoze each and everything, Father, and we will carry on and do what we need to do. Father, we ask your blessings upon us today. We pray for the sick. We pray for the bereaved families. We pray for those who have been injured, Father. We pray for peace, Father. We pray for love. We pray for unity. We pray for equality. We pray for fairness. Father, let those who are around decision-making tables and in positions of representation stop spinning, Father, and start being truthful. Start, Father, being of service and offering that all-important leadership. Father, we've highlighted various things this evening, but Father, empower us to bring forth the solutions. Bless, guide, and protect us, we pray now, Father. Those who are troubled, Father, we pray that, Father, they not just be offered a shoulder to cry upon, but, Father, they be offered strength to take the next steps. Father, we pray for our children right now. We pray for them that are in education, Father. We pray that there is a continuous blessing upon each and every one. And Father, we pray for the church and all the houses of faith right now, Father. And as many of us are trying to link arms together, Father, and stand in that spirit of oneness, we ask, Father, right now, that you continue to bless us, we pray. As we step out forward in Jesus' name, amen. We just want to thank you for joining us this evening. God bless you all. And this is Bishop Desmond Jadu. I want to thank you. And do remember tomorrow in the Widrush National Organization meeting. And we will see you on Sunday, 11 o'clock for morning worship. And at 8:30 for Shine a Light. Until then, God bless you. And thank you for joining.